G'day and welcome back. So today we're looking at generating proxies in DaVinci Resolve. So at the moment here I have a couple of clips. I'm working on a short film and these clips are shot on RAW using 4K. So I'm getting some bad playback. So what I want to do is I want to generate some proxies. Now there's two different ways to generate proxies and one of them is within DaVinci Resolve and the other one is using the plugin which all Resolve comes with. That is the proxy generator and that is the one we're going to look at first. So access this. You want to go down to your start menu. Now, obviously, I'm using a Windows computer, so I'm not sure how you would do it on a Mac computer. So let me know in the comments below how you would do that. So when I start meeting, let's go down to Blackmagic Design. Now we can come down to Blackmagic Proxy Generator, and this is where we can select it. In the free version, it is called Blackmagic Proxy Generator Lite, but it does the exact same thing. So just click that. Now Resolve may come up with a Explorer window, so just close that off. So now we have our Blackmagic proxy generator. So this is where we get to choose where we're going to put those proxy files and where we're going to source those clips from. What we want to do first is we want to go to add. Now we want to find where our footage is because this is where Resolve is going to link those source files to make those proxy generated files. So I come down to my local disk here and I've already made a folder called short. Now this is where my footage is. So I just click select folder. So now that Resolve has worked out where those source files are, it can link those source files to make those proxies. So it's telling me that I need 177 megabyte free to generate those proxies, which of course I do. So now we get to create our proxies in one of these formats. I'm going to choose the first one here, which will give me the least amount of space required. So next thing to do would be come up to here and click start. Now it's going to generate those files for me. Now this is not my whole project. I'm just using a couple of clips because Resolve does take a while to generate proxies, especially when it comes to big footage like raw or log footage. So just be aware of that. So we'll just wait for this to finish and I'll just skip ahead. Now the Resolve has finished making those proxies. We can see where those files have gone. So come down to show. Now Resolve will pull up this window here. And as you can see, here is our source files, the ones we made those proxies from. So Resolve hasn't deleted them, it hangs on to them. Now we can go our proxy generated files, which are located in the proxy folder, so the subfolder for our source clips. And if we just click this and then right click properties, now we have a very small file. So 40 megabyte, so obviously very small. Now in Resolve, we're actually not using those proxy files just yet. That's because we haven't selected Resolve to use them. So all you have to do is come up to playback, proxy handling, and then go across to prefer proxies. Now, if we make this a lot bigger, we've got this little camera thing here, which is telling us that it's using these proxies. The footage looks a little worse now because we're working in a lower resolution, but we're going to get that smooth playback. Now, one thing to be really careful about is when you've finished editing your project, to make sure you're not grading in those proxy files. Otherwise, you've been grading in a low resolution. So what we can do here is simply go up to playback, proxy handling, and just click disable all proxies. Now, we've got that high resolution file back so we can grade our project. Now, let's say you finish your project and you don't need those proxy files anymore. You don't have to go to the folder and delete them. Of course, that's one way to do it, but you can use the proxy generator to delete those files. So in our proxy generator here, all I'd have to do is highlight the one that I'm working in, which is obviously short, and then go to remove. Now, just one thing before I do this, if you're generating proxies, you can still actually keep working in Resolve. So you don't need to have this thing right in front of you and just waiting for it to finish. You can actually do other things like grading and things like that. I think that's a really important thing to remember. Also, another thing before we delete this is if you were to accidentally press remove or click this off, so we'll just do this, it hasn't actually deleted those proxies. It still kept that information. So if we came back to a project at a later time and we didn't delete those proxies and then we clicked add and then we select the path that we were before, those proxies are already there. So don't freak out if you've accidentally clicked off the Blackmagic proxy generator or you've accidentally clicked remove, they're still saved. But we want to delete them. So again, make sure this is highlighted and just click delete proxies. Now it comes up this little warning, of course, because we all need warnings, and then click delete. And now if we go show, we no longer have that proxy folder, which had all our proxy files in it, in our source file folder. Now, let's say that you've made a new project and all your files are low resolution except for one. So we don't want Resolve to go back and proxy all those files. All we want to do is generate a proxy from this clip here. So instead of doing it with the proxy generator, we can do it within Resolve itself. Now we need to set up a couple of settings first. So let's go down to Project Settings. Now under Master Settings, go all the way down, Optimize Media and Render Cache. So this is where we get to choose what our proxy media resolution is going to be. So I'm going to choose 1/8, which is going to give us some pretty ugly looking footage, but we're going to get nice smooth playback, and then click Save. So before we do that, we can actually do another setting. So under DaVinci Resolve, Preferences, Media Storage, this is where you get to choose your proxy generation location. Proxy subfolders in media file location, use project settings, which is the one we just did, or ask when creating. So we can just use project settings and then click save. Now come up to playback, proxy handling, and prefer proxies. So now all we need to do is highlight this clip here, right click, and come up to generate proxy media. And Resolve's gonna do its thing, and it's gonna generate that proxy media for us. And it's only gonna do that clip. It's not gonna do the other clips that's inside Resolve. So now Resolve has generated that proxy media. And again, as you can see, we have that little camera next to our footage here, which is telling us it's using proxy media. So if we scrub through our footage here, it's looking very, very dodgy, as in we have a low resolution. Again, when you're going to grade, make sure you're not working in this low resolution. So just playback, proxy handling, disable all proxies. Now we have that nice 4K high resolution footage. Now the only thing about this one is you actually have to delete those files manually. You can't delete it from Resolve. So you need to find a location. So project settings and find working folders, proxy generation location, and go in there and then delete all those files that you're no longer needing when you finish your project. Anyway, that is the video for today. Proxy media, it's something that will help you out in the future and in the present. If you want to see anything else, make sure to comment below. More than happy to help you out. Thanks again for watching, and I've been Drew, and have a great day.